The Human Sciences Research Council, in partnership with the University of the Free State's QwaQwa campus, is set to unveil its findings on democracy at 30. The groundbreaking study is in celebration of 30 years of democracy here in South Africa, and those findings will then be shared in a dialogue over 2 days at the University of the Free State's QwaQwa campus. For more on this study, we've roped in Dr Mokhantso Makoae, Research Director in the Developmental, Capable and Ethical State Research Division at the Human Sciences Research Council. Doctor, thank you so much for your time today. Welcome. Please give us a little bit of background of how this initiative actually came about, as well as its main objectives.
Thank you. Thanks very much, and good afternoon to the viewers. This study was actually conceptualized in 2023, and that was after our CEO, Dr. Professor Sarah Msweza, joined the HSRC, and she came up with this project to basically celebrate 2024 and to help HSRC as a research council. You know, HSRC is a statutory council, and the idea was to help HSRC to be part of the celebrations as it should be. And this project was therefore intended to help HSRC to celebrate and also to help communities reflect on the 30 years of democracy.
Mm-hmm. Doctor, I mean, this year, as you rightly pointed out. Yes, go ahead, Doctor.
I was saying that the objectives included basically to celebrate, but also to reflect on this 30 years of democracy, to also provide a platform where ordinary people who are not technocrats, who may not have influence on our democracy on a day-to-day basis, can have their voice heard and share their voice with the nation. So those were some of the objectives.
Very interesting indeed, Doctor. I was just saying, I mean, with this year, quite a lot was happening with the elections. We were literally gauging the past 30 years, all of the misses, as well as the challenges and some great achievements. So the findings, as we understand, are actually being tabled today and tomorrow. But what interesting facts did you actually uncover that you can share with us today at this stage? And where can the rest of us, as well as the public, get access to them?
You know, what we can share at this moment, Criselda, is what is happening in QwaQwa for these 2 days. And it started today. It will end tomorrow. We are launching the report that is based on the research that we did in QwaQwa from November in 2023, and which ended earlier this year. And like we're saying, the idea was to have a moment where we can look inwards and look outwards and say what it is that we can say is exciting to us and what still needs to be done. And what is interesting is that, remember, QwaQwa is a former homeland, and it was established very late in the 1970s to be a homeland for Basotho people in South Africa. And what we're finding is that people have mixed feelings about the celebrations. At times they even feel like they have no reason to celebrate. But when they celebrate, they emphasize issues around service delivery, that a lot of people have benefited post 1994, of what they have received as part of development that is led by the state: housing, provision of services, basic services, education, water, and electricity. They also lament some of the lack of change that has happened, and in some places, some regression that some communities have experienced. So there are these mixed feelings, but overall, people realize that what they have under democracy is way better than what they had before democracy. But they would want to see more efforts being put into changing their lives so that they can also realize this aspiration of better life for all.
That was great indeed, Doctor. Speaking of lamenting there, I suppose these findings also contain solutions as well, since they are being shared on a public platform. But what about taking them further? Will you also be sharing these with the various government entities as part of course, their research data that they could also assist when they embark on future related projects?
The HSRC will share these findings with government. And I indicated that this is one of those flagship projects of the HSRC, and it is led by the CEO as the PI. And this is important in itself. But what is also important is this that we have obtained from the people in the communities, local communities, and communities that we usually categorize as marginalized. And what we are going to do is what we usually do, given our role as a statutory council in the country. We are going to produce products from this research that will communicate the findings of this study in a distilled manner. And that includes policy briefs that we're going to share and present with various decision makers. And we are also going to share in different platforms with other stakeholders, especially community-based organizations that are involved in development. And this is part of what we're doing today. The platform that we had at the University of Free State in QwaQwa is basically that we had a forum of different stakeholders who came to participate and provide their view on what we say we have found in QwaQwa. And they have provided their perspective. And their perspective is not different from the lived experiences that we got from the people who we interacted with when we were collecting the data. So this is encouraging that there are no disjunctures between the views of different people or people who have different positions in their localities. And we are going to continue to share this in different community forums. And this is what will be happening in QwaQwa. But the study report also is going to be available on the HSRC website, as well as those other products that I'm referring to.
We're looking forward to it, Doctor. Thank you so much for making time to be with us this afternoon.